Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss how to use AMOS graphics to draw a path diagram. Before doing so, I suggest reading chapters 1 and 2 in the textbook by Byrne 2010 to gain basic understanding of the structural equation modeling method, such as observed variables, latent variables, exogenous variables, endogenous variables, and different models such as confirmatory effect analysis model, full structural model, model fit, and post hoc analysis. These are important terms and concepts that we need to understand before using AMOS. Note that construct is the same as latent variable or factor, so I will use these terms interchangeably. In addition, AMOS uses the term indicators for observed variables. AMOS Graphics is a software with graphic tools that allow us to draw the path diagram for our model, either confirmatory effect analysis model or full structural model. The first step is to open the data file. Since IBM bought AMOS, we can use data in text or SAR file with AMOS. To open a data file, we go to File or the menu and select Data Files. Or we can just click on the icon Select Data Files on the left panel. The Data Files window will open and click File Name to select the data file. Then we browse to the file. In this example, I use a text file cvsec.txt. Click Open and then click OK. The data file has been opened by AMOS. To see variables in the data file, click the icon List Variables in the dataset on the left panel. A pop-up window opens and shows us all variables in the dataset. We then can expand the window to see all variables. The process is the same if you use SAR files. Let's draw a diagram. First, I will draw a diagram for the CFA model or confirmatory effect analysis model. AMOS is one of the most user-friendly software packages in SEM with many graphic tools. Some other packages such as Lizeral or MP Plus might still require writing commands or scripts. However, it still takes time to get used to AMOS, so it is important to practice with the software ASAP. To draw a latent variable with corresponding observed variables, I will click on the icon Draw a latent variable or add an indicator on the left panel. In AMOS, indicators mean observed variables. The pointer will change and I draw a latent variable in the main window. Note that the latent variable must be oval. To add observed variables to this latent variable, we just click on the latent variable, which is the oval. AMOS will add the observed variable, error term, and arrows. In this case, we have 9 observed variables for this construct, so I click 9 times. We also can see that AMOS automatically adds the fixed value of 1 to each regression path of the error terms, and only one fixed parameter for the regression path between the latent variable and an observed variable. Note that without these fixed parameters, AMOS will not run, so this feature is convenient for us. Again, these fixed values of 1 are to ensure that our model is not unidentified. I want to rotate the observed variables of this latent variable structure to make it easier to see. On the left, we click Rotate the indicators of a latent variable. The pointer changes, and we click on the latent variable. All indicators will rotate. I want them on the left side of the latent variable. So that is the first latent variable or construct structure of this model. Note that this structure is a little oversized. Do not worry about this. When we have all parts of the model, we can fit them all in the page. This CFA model has 3 constructs, and I follow the same steps. Click Draw a latent variable or add an indicator on the left and draw the latent variable in the main window. Make sure these ovals have the same size. This latent variable has 5 observed variables. So I click 5 times. Then click rotate indicators of a latent variable on the left and rotate all indicators to the left. Now I want to move the second construct structure up a little bit to fit better. In order to do so, we need to use the select tool. We have select all objects. Select one object at a time and deselect all. In this case, we use select one object at a time to move this construct only. We need to select all objects of this construct, including ovals, rectangles, and circles. Make sure that you don't miss any object. On the left, we click move objects. Then we drag the entire construct structure up a little bit. Then click deselect all. We have a third construct, or latent variable, with 8 observed variables. We follow the same steps to add the latent variable and add observed variables. We also need to move the construct a little bit to the left to align all constructs. Even though we do not need our model to look great to run, we still want a model with aligned components so we can add that to our report later on. The model is a little oversized. To fix it, on the left we select resize the path diagram to fit on a page. AMOS will automatically fit everything on the same page. The last part of this CFA diagram is the covariance between latent variables. We click on the double arrow on the left and draw the covariance between each pair of constructs. Since we have 3 constructs, we'll need 3 covariance arrows. If we have 4 constructs, we'll need 6 covariance arrows, etc. We have the diagram for the CFA model, but we still need to add variables to the diagram to link it to the dataset. I do not suggest typing names for observed variables because any misspelling or mismatch will cause errors. The right way to do this is to click List Variables in the dataset to open the pop-up window that lists all observed variables from the dataset. Then we drag and drop each variable to the corresponding rectangle based on the construct structure. For instance, for construct 1, we have item 1, item 2, item 3, item 6, item 8, item 13, item 14, item 16, and item 20. If you double click on one variable, the object properties window opens and you will see the variable name. You can add the variable label if you want to. You also can change the font size. As I understand, with AMOS, we'll have to make these changes for each item at a time, which could be time consuming, unless we write some codes in AMOS. Hopefully, AMOS will come up with a better solution in the future. We also need to add variable names for the error terms. In this case, we can name these error terms the way we want. I will use a simple name, E1, E2, etc. So we click on the circle and enter E1 to the variable name. We repeat the entire process for all observed variables. And here is the diagram with completed observed variables and error terms. To make sure the model is not unidentified, we check the fixed parameters in the model. That is explained in the book. The only thing left in completing the CFA diagram is to add names to the latent variables or constructs. Click on the first construct and the object properties window opens. We will name this construct F1 and add the label emotional exhaustion. I also add F1 to the label to keep track of the construct. Note that there should not be any spaces in the variable name. But we can add spaces or use enter for the label. For the second construct, we name it F2 and the label will be depersonalization. Then we add F2 as well. The third construct has a name F3 and the label personal accomplishment and F3. This is the complete CFA diagram which is linked to the actual data set. We'll test this model in the next video. That is how to draw a diagram using AMOS. Thank you and bye now.